This is already quite an achievement, the very fact that they are taking place. Think about what was a few weeks ago only. The fact that we have been asking, everyone been asking, certainly the UN, we need to have the Russians and Americans sitting together, and not enough, also have those regional players who do have an influence. Right. Tomorrow, we believe we will have Iran and Saudi Arabia, Russia and America, and many other countries. That's already quite an achievement. Next, it cannot just be a procedural or a protocolar meeting. It needs to be addressing the real issues. And the real issue is military solution. We can see it will not lead anywhere. You need a parallel political solution based on a transformative new change of governance in Syria. That can be achieved if everyone agrees upon it.
You mentioned Iran, you mentioned Saudi Arabia. Of course, those are important regional players, the United States and Russia as well. But of course, missing from this list are any Syrian representatives. Why weren't any invited to this round of talks?
The reason is very simple. The Syrians themselves have been telling us and telling everyone that they will never be able to have a common ground unless those who have been sponsoring, supporting, helping, or pushing them have been actually having a common agreement. The Syrian different groups and the Syrian government will be involved. They need to be involved. That's why we have established the so-called working groups, which mm-hmm. have been waiting for starting working, but they need the energy of the international and regional political support. We have learned it. Otherwise, they will not be able to agree.
Okay, so right now we have Iran, which is one big difference with all the other talks regarding Syria. What will Iran's presence, what difference will it make, the fact that it is now involved?
Well, a big difference. First of all, the fact that in the same room you will have Iran and Saudi Arabia together with the United States, Russia, Turkey, and many other countries who are having an influence and can have even more influence in finding a solution. Mm-hmm. Secondly, the fact that Iran, and it's not a secret, they are heavily involved in Syria, they are strongly supporting the current government, and therefore they do have a possibility of realizing too that if they are not part of the solution, there will not be a solution. And we know that they know that there is no military solution.
But was Saudi Arabia asked for its backing, its approval, before Iran was invited? I mean, was there that level of discussion before, do you know?
I am not going to elaborate on that. The most important thing is the facts, and we should look at facts. And the fact is that Saudi Arabia and Iran and these countries are going to be sitting in one small room in Vienna tomorrow. And that room could make history if we start talking seriously about political process.
If you look, and you have more experience than most anyone on this, two of your predecessors essentially stepped down from the role you hold now, saying, we just can't get this done. Look at the timeline ahead of you, when do you think Syrian representatives, because nothing will be done without them, will be involved in talks? At what point do you think that can happen?
Imagine for a moment that we need to be not only visionary but hopeful, because the Syrian people need to have some feeling that the international community is seriously this time looking at the political process. So imagine that tomorrow the meeting goes well, or at least maintains the momentum. I repeat, the momentum. Mm-hmm. Imagine that takes place. We could engage very quickly the Syrian people and the different entities quite quickly.
Have you ever been, is this the most hopeful you've been so far? Can we say that? Is that fair to say about your state of mind right now?
What you can say is my state of mind is that I'm cautious. We have had so many ups and downs in this tragic history, but it's the first time that we are seeing a serious, genuine intention of meeting and sitting around the table. From that point of view, not only I'm hopeful, we are also determined to not miss this opportunity.